Last time, it was our first challenge submission, as I worked on a dream home for Addictive G. This time, we're knocking down that old hospital in an attempt to build a better one. So welcome to the big project. Today's challenge comes from Rai Minora, a close friend and content creator here on YouTube. She's given me a sim with a project that I'll try to complete. This is Michaela Rowan, a top-level doctor that has recently moved into the neighborhood. Michaela is family-oriented, cheerful, and childish. Having been posted to Willow Creek Hospital as chief of staff, Michaela has spent the last week getting to know the facility and its staff. She's found that the hospital isn't quite up to par as a center for care and treatment, and has acquired funding to refurbish it from scratch. I'll be working to help fulfill her desires by building a children-oriented hospital on the existing lot. While it may be a children's hospital, I'm hoping to keep it universal enough for all residents, as well as ensure that it represents the core values of hospital care through the architecture. With that in mind, here's hoping that Michaela ends up with a hospital that allows her to care for her patients in a more nurturing environment. The concept of children's hospitals appear to originate from church-based care, where many Christians sought to care for the most vulnerable, in this case, the ill and poor. Many early centers focused on caring for abandoned children and orphans. The idea is that these children could be raised until they were adults and then integrated back into society. One such institution was the Foundling Hospital, established in 1741 by a man called Thomas Karam. Karam is thought to be responsible for the founding of the world's first incorporated charity, as well as the UK's first children's charity. The hospital offered abandoned infants with rehabilitation and thereafter teaching of a skill or trade that enabled them to make a living as adults. While the original building was demolished, the Foundling Hospital charity continues to exist as Karam. A dive further down the history books brings us to the Florence Hospital of the Innocent, a charity-based orphanage that was established in 1445. A curious thing to note about this hospital is that children could be placed into a horizontal wheel so that the identity of the parents would remain unknown. A wider spread of children's hospitals occurred in the 19th century over concerns of many children living in poor living conditions. Initially funded by donations, these hospitals were then replaced by formally recognized ones after lacking the required means to sustain their services. The first of these new hospitals opened in France in 1802 as the Hôpital des Enfants Malades, if that was pronounced right at least. Today, children's hospitals are now a commonplace for children of all ages to seek care and treatment. Many of these offer facilities oriented towards childhood care, including special play areas or child-focused wings of medicine and treatment. With the refurbishment of Willow Creek Hospital, let's hope that we'll offer the region a new hospitable hospital for their needs. Welcome to the Eco Children's Hospital, Willow Creek's new premier healthcare facility. The hospital echoes the value of sustainability of life and the environment through the use of materials, including reclaimed wooden planks that form the bulk of the walls, floors, and roofs. The theme of life and vitality is represented through the lush greenery growing across the build. Louvre-style roofs protect the hospital from the elements, while also keeping the interior open for natural ventilation. The interior carries the values of openness, with as little of the building sealed off from the environment as possible, minimizing the disconnect between the outside world. Playful touches of color are used sparingly to keep the youthful nature of the hospital, while high ceilings, glass facades, and skylights allow for natural light to flood into the interior of the hospital. Meanwhile, aspects of nature have been incorporated that bring elements of the exterior inside. This includes the indoor fields, as well as trees planted throughout the atrium. Not to mention further green touches in other areas. The hospital offers 10 beds for long-term treatment, as well as play areas for children, among other facilities. With all this on board, the Eco Children's Hospital hopes to ensure that Willow Creek's health will be well taken care of for years to come. Overall, it was a pretty successful day for Michaela and her team. Here's hoping the hospital continues to serve them well. Thanks for watching this episode of The Big Project. Eco Children's Hospital is now available on The Sims 4 Gallery to download. Also, thanks again to Vimanora for this episode's challenge. If you would like to submit a challenge for a future episode, get in touch and we'll see how things go.